Section 31. Sonaka said, O son of a Suta, what was Indra's fault and what is act of carelessness? How was Garuda born in consequence of the ascetic penances of the Valakilyas? Why also Kashyapa, a Brahman and the king of birds for a son? Why too was he invincible of all creatures and unslayable of all? Why also was that ranger of the skies capable of going to every place at will and of mustering at will any measure of energy? If these are described in the Purana, I should like to hear them. Sauti said, what thou asks me is indeed the subject of the Purana. O twice born one, listen as I briefly recite it all. Once upon a time, when the lord of creation, Kashyapa, was engaged in a sacrifice from desire of offspring, the rishis, the gods and the Gandharvas all gave him help, and Indra was appointed by Kashyapa to bring the sacrifice of fuel, and with him those ascetics, the Valakilyas, and all the other deities, and the lord Indra, taking up, according to his own strength, a weight that was mountain-like, brought it without any fatigue. And he saw on the way some rishis of bodies of the measure of the thumb, all together carrying one single stalk of a palasa, Bhutia frondosa leaf. And those rishis were, for want of food, very lean-fleshed, almost merged into their own bodies. And they were so weak that they were such afflicted and sunk in the water that collected in an indentation on the road produced by the hoof of a cow. And Purandara, proud of his strength, beheld them with surprise, and laughing at them in derision, soon left them behind, insulting them, besides by passing over their heads. And those rishis, being thus insulted, were filled with rage and sorrow, and they made preparations for a great sacrifice, at which Indra was terrified. Here was Saunaka, of the wish for accomplishment of which those vow-observing, wise and excellent ascetics poured clarified butter of the sacrificial fire with loudly uttered mantras. There shall be another Indra of all gods, capable of going everywhere at will, and of mastering at will any measure of energy, and striking fear into the present king of the gods. By the fruit of our ascetic penance, let one arise, fleet as the mind, and fierce withal, and the lord of the celestials of the 100 sacrifices, having come to know of this, became very much alarmed and sought the protection of vow-observing Kashyapa. And the Prajapati Kashyapa, hearing everything from Indra, went to the Valakilyas and asked them if their sacrifice had been successful. And those truth-speaking rishis replied to him, saying, let it be as thou sayest. And the Prajapati Kashyapa, pacifying them, spake on to them as follows. By the word of Brahmana, this one, Indra, hath been made the lord of the three worlds. He ascetics, ye also are striving to create another Indra. Ye excellent ones, it behoveth you not to falsify the word of Brahman. Let not also this purpose for accomplishing which ye are striving be rendered futile. Let there spring an Indra, lord of winged creatures, endued with excess of strength. Be gracious unto Indra. Will is a suppliant before you. And the Valakilyas, thus addressed by Kashyapa, after offering reverence to that first of the Munis, the Prajapati Kashyapa spake on to him. The Valakilyas said, O Prajapati, this sacrifice of all is for an Indra. Indeed, this hath also meant for a son being born unto thee. Let this task be now left to thee, and in this matter do whatever thou seest to be good and proper. Sauti continued, meanwhile moved by the desire of offspring that called the good daughter of Daksha, the vow-absorbing, amiable and fortunate Vinata, her ascetic penances over, having purified herself with a bath in that season, and connubial companionship might prove fruitful, approached our Lord. When Kashyapa spake unto her, "Respected one, the sacrifice commenced by me hath borne fruit. What hath been desired by thee shall come to pass. Two heroic sons shall be born unto thee, who shall be the lords of the three worlds. By the penances of the Valakilyas and by virtue of the desire with which I commenced my sacrifice, those sons shall be of exceedingly good fortune and worshipped in the three worlds." The illustrious Kashyapa spake unto her again, "Bear thou these auspicious seeds with great care. These two will be lords of all winged creatures. These heroic rangers of the skies will be respected in all the worlds and capable of assuming any form at will." And the Prajapati, gratified with all that took place, then addressed Indra of the 100 sacrifices, saying, "Thou shalt have two brothers of great energy and prowess, who shall be to thee even as the helpmates. From them no injury shall result unto thee. Let thy sorrow cease. Thou shalt continue as the lord of all. Let not, however, the utterers of the name of Brahma be ever again slighted by thee, nor let the very wrathful ones, whose words are even the thunderbolt, be ever again insulted by thee." Indra thus addressed went to heaven, his fears dispelled, and Vinata also, her purpose fulfilled, was exceedingly glad. And she gave birth to two sons, Aruna and Garuda. And Aruna of undeveloped body became the forerunner of the sun, and Garuda was vested with the lordship over the birds. O thou of Bhrigu's race, hear now to the mighty achievement of Garuda. So ends the 31st section in the Astika Parva of the Adi Parva.